Technology as communicative space. The greatest change which has been brought about by the internet is that it has created new spaces for communication in which anybody or everybody can share and can create new material. So anybody can be an author by simply going to the internet and creating your own material and sharing it with others. Because internet has brought about new forms of multi-modal writing in which various types of writing can be combined together. For example, written, visual, images, even music and sound can be incorporated in this type of a writing. So these technologies which are offered by the internet can be used for language learning and teaching. By teachers as well as by students, where students can create and share their own texts which they have created themselves, and they can bring in their own real life experiences and share them with others. Also, digital media has made it possible to teach English as a form of a text in which all of these various aspects of multimodal literacies can be incorporated. Especially digital stories, which are an important tool for teaching language and have been used in business as well as in medical scenarios. These are important sources for teaching language. So the use of technology is reflected not only in teaching, but also in socializing. It reflects the learner's need to participate in learning communities and for enhancing their literacy. Places where this can happen are through the email, through chat, through Twitter, blogs, Facebook, and they all have their roles, not inside the classroom, but outside as well, which can create spaces for social networking and hence lead to literacy. The value of immersion in a disciplinary discourse has long been emphasized by ESP practitioners, where the learners are totally immersed into the discourse, which is the teaching goal. So the internet provides a vast field. The importance and the value of field trips has been emphasized by ESP teachers, in which students are totally immersed in the discourse, which is the goal of that particular teaching point. So we can look at the internet as also a vast field in which learners can be totally immersed into the disciplinary discourse. The learners can interact with others and share their own experiences, listening to others and interacting with others, and thereby immersing themselves into that particular discourse. Besides this, the open exercise and the virtual worlds which are available on the internet are also important tools for teaching, because they provide opportunities for interaction in real time, which the learners can avail according to their convenience. So for the teachers, the dilemma is that this sheer amount of information and technology which is available on the internet becomes sometimes overwhelming. And none of this has been actually designed for language teaching purposes, and none of them offers a straight out of the box solution for teaching problems. The choice has to be made by the teacher himself or herself. What do you need from this huge amount of information which is available, and what is the requirement of your course? So this can be used as an important literary resource for the teacher, but of course the teacher has to be flexible and it has to put in a certain amount of effort in order to choose and pick what best suits the need of the learners. Also, another additional problem which is posed by the use of information from the internet is the intellectual property rights and the attitude towards plagiarism. Teachers have to think about what is the difference between the commercial and educational use of this intellectual property which is available on the internet. Because the internet has frequently been blamed for the plagiarism epidemic, students can take material from the internet, copy and paste it and use it as their own. So teachers have to think about that although the internet is a rich source for authentic materials, but how best to use them and how to be aware of the rights and constraints which are there in the use of these authentic materials which are available on the internet. So we can see that there has been an increase in the number of plagiarism cases, where this ease with which material can be cut and pasted has led to a situation in which teachers have to think about how to inform and make their learners aware about this the intellectual property rights of this information. So they have to integrate the rules of using this material along with the language teaching. Another issue which teachers frequently face is about the access to this information, about the digital divide which is there in who can access this information on the internet and who can't. Also, not only about who can access it, but also about the speed and the quality of this access. And then the right to the uncensored material which is there. So, and then how to participate also in the production of material which is available on the internet. Not everyone would be able to get their things published on the internet. So this, although this issue of disparity to access and production of material on the internet is basically a political and economic factor, and one response to this has been the availability of open access materials which anybody can avail on the internet. And there are several websites which are available to teach and learn English on the internet. Another concern about how to use these websites is again regarding the use of information from Wikipedia and Facebook, with which students frequently interact and use, and the use of these two websites is quite popular among students, where privacy becomes a major issue in the use of these, because sometimes the Facebook can contain embarrassing content which can easily be deleted if the student or the learner wants to. Employers want to usually, when they want to hire, they access information about the future employees from the Facebook. It is the teacher's job now to balance how to use this information and also make the learners aware about the constraints which are there in the use of information which is available on the internet.